So heading east then. Ah, slime. Not sure how many these battles I'm gonna keep in, maybe just one more. And then I'll start fast forwarding it. I mean, even one more, I'm not sure if I should keep. So we had purpur slime, we had wine slime. I'm not sure what else. If the other one was just called slime. Oh, now we have yellow slime. Oh wow, we killed one already? Wow. So yeah, if we're lucky enough, we destroy one in one round. Well, let's heal Drobaneer again. Cast a spell. Ooh, Satine went blind. I have a spell for that, though. Of course she missed the target. She's blind. So he's... Drobaneer is good. Good man could use some healing. Heal blindness. Satine. Now these, I know I don't have to be using them, but I'm mostly just freeing up weight and space. So I'm gonna use this lesser healing potion on a Griban. Attack. I'll have her try to attack anyway. Griban hitting nice hits in there. That's a healing 3 with that lesser one. That potion. Attacking. Griban still needs healing anyway. Three down, one to go. My healing was interrupted. Oh, I didn't want to be waiting. Again. really like that they save some of these tunes for the end. Makes it extra special, you know, when you're getting near the end like this. Alright, so I've been here. I'm just gonna go forward, keep going west. I think I saved, I'm not sure, so I'll do it. Is this where I've been, or have I been? No, I've not been here. Endless doors and corridors. Ah! A battle to fast forward. Alright, so during the battle, Trasric was petrified, and his little icon disappears from the battle grid when that happens, so we can't de-petrify him during combat. I have the spell, so hopefully I can now. Good. I'm pretty low on mana right now. Should I see what's around the corner? What is this? Huh. Never seen this in a dungeon before. I mean, obviously a support, right? A support thing? But to what end? Like, I've never seen it in a dungeon, so it's just something they added for extra flavor, or does it have a significance of some kind? In any case, let's see if we can rest. We all have plenty of rations. Although Silk doesn't need any, but I doubt... Well, he doesn't have that many rations. I can take some, and Gribban is full. I doubt anyone could take 131 rations. Nope, okay. How about Drobaneer all but one? No. Okay. Alright, so gonna rest and fast forward. I guess I forgot to restart the recording. I was just checking Tragic Spell Learning Points. He does have 60 up from 36, so he indeed got more upon leveling up. So you can take any more sling stones here. Not. What'd I do? 15? 10? You can take 10. Getting close. About 3. Nope. 2. Yes. So use the Globe of Harakht, however you say it. Armor Protection 3. Weapons Power 3. Anti-Magic 3. Still has plenty of mana left over. Doesn't even use half our mana, it's pretty awesome. The only thing we really use for her might be haste. Which I might take advantage of. Oh, For identification, we have Joe Benir's necklace. For levitation or levitation, we have a pipe of levitation. Magic compass we won't need. We have a compass now, right? I don't think it would do anything other than that. Yeah, mass haste and teleport. Alright, so... Alright, so this is the dead end. So coming back out of here. Yeah, heading forward. I have not been here? No. Let's go switch us. But I went ahead and west towards that skeleton. Even though... keep finding nothing. Actually, I'm gonna head north towards this. But these things just seem to be... nothing we can interact with. Another door right here. Dead end. Another. So all these little dead ends. I wonder why. Am I being teleported? No, this actually real. Okay. Because it's pretty much identical. Oh, we've got a chest here. In this chest, you find some potions and magic scrolls. Now, this is the weak mana potion. I'll give it to Silk. This is the good mana potion. I'll give it to him, too. Salvation. 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 Magic sphere. We have an item with an effect like that. Reincarnation. I know that, don't I? Conversion of ashes? Conversion of dust? I think conversion of dust is new. Earthquake and hurricane. Is hurricane the one we were looking for? I think it might be. If so, I'm very excited. Page 37, I believe. Black magic. Hurricane, look at that. Reduces by 128 to 256. This affects all as well. I say he'd be able to use that once. Hopefully, even once. It takes 100 spell points just to use it. Spell learning points 50. He has 60, so... lucky. I'm trying to... damn it. Yeah. Alright, so that's exciting. What'd it say again? Sorry guys, I know I can't keep stuff in my head. It's too exciting. It's all way too exciting. Okay, 100 spell points to cast. 50 spell learning points. Just shy. He could almost cast it twice with full mana. Well, if I have someone feeding him potions, he could cast it again. That's awesome. That is really awesome. And then Earthquake, I think he knows. Let's just give this... Wait a second. Give... He can't even hold it right now. Conversion of Dust. I think that's the one... I think I have Ashes, not Dust. This is exciting. I was waiting for these. Okay, so yes, I have reincarnation. I have conversion of ashes, not dust. Silk help out with potions on people. This is the lower amount of potion. This is the good one. Now as far as Tragic, he has Earthquake, I think? Yes. So just double checking. Reincarnation. Conversion of Ashes, Earthquake. Now, Magic Sphere... That, I believe, is... Gray magic, but... The way it's written, I don't understand. Magic Sphere. 80 spell point. 80 just to cast it. Covers the 6 previous spells each at level 3. So for that... So I guess we cast it once and we get Light 3, Armor Protection 3, Weapons Power 3, Anti-Magic 3, Clairvoyance, which I don't know what that is, at 3, which doesn't even get that high. Wait. Oh, it does. Went the wrong way. And Invisibility 3. X-ray vision allows you to see through walls. But that didn't work out for me, though, trying to use that. So it's 80 to cast, 95 spell learning points. So I can cast it. I don't have anything else for her to use, really. I'll take it. Maybe it saves mana. How many... I should, like, just stop going back at this. Okay, so it's 80 to cast that. This takes 12, 30, 42, wait, 12 and 30, yeah, 42, 72, anti-magic, Plus then I might get to see what clairvoyance and invisibility does. Invisibility, I guess, monsters don't see you. You get to attack them if you want to, I guess. I'm sure you had a better description of what these spells do, like a nice paragraph, Dungeons and Dragons type paragraph spell description. So in order to cast armor protection 3, just these three, it's 50 6, 7, 8, 9, 95. So I might as well, because I'm always casting those three. So I will save 15 mana, plus I'll have clairvoyance 3 and invisibility 3. So I might as well, yeah, just get that for her. It's free, and she has a spell learning points. I don't think there's anything else for her to learn. So yeah, I'll take it. Sorry guys, I take magic very seriously. Magic sphere. Now you'd think maybe I should pick up some reincarnation. But I have so many things that do that. Not only can I cast that, but I think the brooch of Gala, I have four castings of it. Gribban has this Staff of Resurrection, eight castings of it, and I think Drobanir might have something as well. Not this. Maybe not him, but somebody else. Gold helmet, maybe. He's got 10. So the four of us can cast this. So I think, if I run out of mana, there's three other people that can cast it, so might as well. I mean, if we do start needing it, just come back here and get the treasure, I guess. Otherwise, we're just carrying around a lot more crap. Well, thank you very much for those goodies. Just take a look at the map really quick, just to see. Sweet. Well, I want to go back and just clear out these two areas, actually. And then our way is forward, other than through the teleporters here. And we just have this, and this. Alright, so do I have this? I have Conversion of Dust, which is, I don't know, I keep doing this, driving myself crazy. Probably driving you guys crazy too. 87. You'll see the difference between conversion of ashes and reincarnation of a burned body. Conversion of dust is reincarnation of a pulverized body. I'm guessing that's stuff that might come up soon, because I've never seen one of us killed in such a way. At least not that I know of. Well, then again, I was turned into ashes when I would put the wrong symbol, the wrong piece of the Amberstar into that thing, so I guess at that point I would need conversion of ashes to change myself back, but I was, you know, I would be the one who would cast that, even if I had the spell, which I did not. I guess at that point, yeah, we'd need that. Alright, so I am saving, because I don't play around with spell failure. Conversion of dust. Alright, managed. So if someone gets pulverized into dust, we can help you out. Now Trazric couldn't get his. Satine is holding hers though. It's magic sphere. Managed. Can I just do a swap then? Well, how about someone take this rune translation? Maybe it's as heavy as a scroll. It's heavier. Somehow it's heavier. Take a few of these potions, I guess. How many of these do I have? 11? Damn. What do they do again? I didn't realize I had so many of them. It's rejuvenation. That, gets rid of unnatural aging. No wonder he's overweight. Can't be used, well that's not true. But, I guess I had like 14 of them or something? I'm not sure how much I started out with. Well, something's going on here. Because now it says I have 16. The amount he has is going up. I didn't think we had that much. Okay, so now I have a lot of them. But I have... Did my weight still go down? I wasn't watching. I can carry, well, probably 4-point-something kilograms. You can take it now. Alright, that's good. That is weird. There is something weird going on with Trazric in general. Because sometimes when I cast his Hailstorm, he has 3 castings of Hailstorm. I'll cast it, and it still says he has 3. He still has 3. And then after a while, it'll catch on and start going down. Now I'm trying to give away potions, and he's gaining potions, plus also giving those potions, apparently, to Dromineer, so... That's kind of crazy. Alright, so I'm saving because that was weird. Let's have him try to learn this spell. Hurricane! Done. Rock you like a hurricane, baby. I can't see how many castings I have, but it's gotta be just one. That's exciting. That is the most powerful spell in the game, unless there's more that is not covered in the manual. I don't see why there would be more not covered. So I pretty much assume we know all the spells. I'm gonna come back around here and check out these two little nooks here. Is it through here? Yeah. Through here, and then, yeah, east. So this is nothing, huh? Not disappointing, because sometimes it's something. East. How do you know I want to go that way? So, going north now. See if we can see anything. I'm surprised there was nothing down there. Going south? And then, I think it would be east, actually. Checking. No, west, actually. Empty. But mapped out. And I could go all the way back to where I was, so I can just go up around this corner. I think I will head west, north, west. Oh, dead end. Alright, so we'll go around this corner. East, north, west. And what it redirected me to where I wanted to go. Okay, door. Dead end. Okay. So other than these teleport fields now, we just have one way to go. I kind of like that. Not like that last dungeon. The entrance... I mean, the second floor was cool with a laboratory and stuff, and there were different ways up there. It was interesting. But that entrance floor... I still get redirected. I saw something blink there. That was a sprawling frickin' floor. Alright. Okay, this is kind of sprawling itself. I see you. I've been watching out. No, no, no. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, here's our answer. Those who might be wondering, yeah. Hurricane is one time. And we don't have a spell, a version of that, unless it's not in the manual. We don't have a version of this spell that attacks a group of enemies. The only option for Hurricane is attacking all, which makes sense, because how would you narrow down a Hurricane? I guess a tornado you can direct towards foes. A storm you can direct, the cloud over them, but a hurricane is just... whoosh. Sorry about that. So, yeah, I was getting really excited. Anyway, yeah. Back to the battle at hand. And just like last time, I was trying to heal him. Drobinir, that is. But the battle ended. good enough. Do you have anything other than slimes? Which way do we... I think we were traveling this way? Was redirecting us while we're doing this. I know what the purpose is. Just an enclosed room. Is there anything special about these blocks? I'm not gonna try them from all angles. Heading south. Redirecting me. It's confusing me because... Alright, the north section, let's try these three blocks. Heading south. Hit one, and I have two more. Here. And here. So let's head all the way south. Make sure we keep heading south. Now facing north. Hit these three. Now in the middle we get redirected. So make sure we keep heading north. Hitting that. That. And that. No, I figure it might be secret. I mean, maybe if you go around all four ways, but I don't feel like messing with it that much. Alright, so we came in here through where we're facing, and there's only one way out. I guess it's to keep you from being able to leave the room. But with the compass, it's a non-issue. Okay, once more. One way to go. So I notice we do have an empty area here. Maybe the teleporter teleports you in here. Similar to the Castle of Many Eye. Or it could be there's a hallway going around this way leading into there. We will find out shortly. There's another one of those pillars. And a door. The end here? Oh, there's a door here. Taking a peek. Yeah, definitely winding around. I see it through the wall. Look at that. Sort of, I guess. It was oozing into the next square.